see you again. So, shall we explain what happened?
Yeah.
Well, I went to your school to surprise you and tell you you were going to be auditioning for Britain's Got Talent.
Yeah.
That's right.
Thank you. Oh, my God.
Was it a nice surprise?
Yeah. How could that not be a good surprise? That's an excellent surprise.
So, Anishwa, tell us how old you are.
7 years old.
And what is your big passion in life?
I care about the environment a lot.
Okay. We're all rooting for you. The stage is yours, Anishwa.
Okay. Thank you.
Oh, I really wanted to do well.
There's no other planet like Earth. It holds plants and flourishes life. It is an amazing creation. A real inspiration. There's no other planet like Earth. Sad off, we've been getting it wrong for much, much, much too long. Cutting down trees, polluting the seas, poaching the animals for accessories. We need to stop getting it wrong. I wish you could see the Tasmanian tiger in its very special, unique attire. And the flying squirrels glide in the open skies, and we can catch the beauty forever in our eyes. The gorgeous peacocks dance their way. The fantastic golden eagles glide in display. But there's no other planet like Earth.
How does it feel, Anishwa?
Very good.
Did you write all that yourself?
Yep.
Yeah, it's a lot of words to remember.
Yeah.
Wow, when did you write that?
When I was about 6 years old.
I mean, that's incredible.
Thank you.
Message is so important. And when I think about somebody like David Attenborough, who's somebody obviously we all look up to and admire, you're the perfect person to follow in his footsteps.
You are a remarkable young man. You should be so proud of yourself. Fantastic audition.
Well, I think we'll look back on, you know, this is the moment when the world met Anishwa. This is the start of something very special, Anishwa, and it's a huge honour to give you your first yes.
OK!
I'm saying yes.
It's a yes from me.
Thank you so much.
And you got four yeses.
Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah!
Oh, yeah!
We are the Five Star Boys.
Great name. Love that. Okay, give us your names and ages, please.
I'm Bo, and I'm 12 years old.
Hello, Bo.
I'm Toby, and I'm 11 years old.
Hello, Toby.
I'm Adam, and I'm 10 years old.
Hello, Adam.
I'm Joey, and I'm 10 years old.
Hello, Joey.
I'm Ollie, and I'm 11 years old.
Okay, well, you've obviously been rehearsing for this. This is the big day. This is the big moment. When you woke up this morning, it was like, what were you thinking?
Nervous as
yeah.
anything.
And excited?
Yeah. Yeah. Is yeah. this real?
And why are you here?
We're trying to spread the word for boys who dance because it's not always easy for us
we get bullied.
We kind of just say to ourselves, we know we're better than them.
But, like, if boys can dance if they want to, it's not going to affect anybody else.
And they're just people that are jealous of you.
Well, we're your friends. If you won, what would you do with the dough?
Buy a flight to go to Disneyland.
Yes!
But also give it to people that need it more than us.
Aww. Like me! Good luck.
Thank you.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall and no one would hear? Even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you, and when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. So let the sun come streaming in, 'cause you'll reach up and you'll rise again. Lift your head and look around, you will be found. You will be found. You will be found. You will be found. You will be found.
Gosh, you've reduced me to tears. I thought it was an extraordinary piece. And I just think you should feel enormously proud of yourselves because it was beautiful. It really was.
It was perfect. You guys are sensational.
Collectively, you were just stunning, and I loved everything about it. You're just the most gorgeous boys, and your parents must be so proud, honestly.
Wow, 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 wow. You know, there was something about you when you walked out, and look, I know this is tough, what you told us, but I promise you, you stand there now as five strong boys who can say to all of those idiots, well, you can't do what we just did. For me, this was the best audition we've seen all day.
Right. Well, now the important part.
Let me kick this off with a yes!
It's a yes from me. It's a yes from me.
You have four yeses.
Stage is yours. Very good luck.
Once upon a time, Jessica's farm, there were lots of animals who brought such a charm. But instead of a sheep, a cow, a horse, a hen, there were animals there that often escaped their pen. Such as a dangerous dog if he entered the bite.
Is that her? Did that actually come out of her?
A terrifying T-Rex to eat you on sight.
That's her.
No, she's not doing that.
And the treacherous tiger breaks eardrums when it roars.
It's her, isn't it?
And the crazy cougar that rips you open with pride. And the delightful dolphin that tells them all where you hide. Jessica's farm, where the animals do intend to cause you harm. So next time you visit, please call ahead, or you can wind up injured or even.
Well done, Jess!
Well done, Jessica. Can we hear the dolphin one more time? I love it.
That
is brilliant. I put a spell on you because you're mine, and you better stop the things you're doing. I say, watch out.
You're not human. How old are you?
9.
Impossible.
9! And sings like that!
That is extraordinary.
It's like you transform, you're this cute 9-year-old, and then you're like, pow! Take that! And we really did. We were under your spell. I loved it, Immy. Well done.
Thank you.
It sounded so retro, so vintage, so otherworldly. It's like you were channeling goodness knows what. It was amazing.
David, you sure you weren't miming?
I'm sure.
No, I was just completely gobsmacked.
Yeah.
It's extraordinary.
Can I ask you a question?
Yeah.
Were you expecting this reaction?
No.
You weren't, were you?
No.
No, that's what makes you so special. You were incredible.
Thank you.
But let's start with David.
I'm going to say yes.
I'm saying yes. It's a yes from me.
I think you got about 5,000 yeses in it.
Once upon a time, many, many years ago, there was a very old man called Simon Cowell.
Don't buzz.
Simon Cowell worked very, very, very hard to come up with an amazing TV show that would entertain the nation.
I've got it. Britain's Got Talent.
Hey, that was my idea.
I'll give you a job if you don't tell a teacher.
Simon now had to find the very best people to make his show perfect.
This is my audition.
Who's up first?
Piers Morgan.
Blah, 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 blah. Blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, that's exactly how he talks.
Wow, Alicia, I didn't like it. I loved it.
She's got the right hair as well.
Next!
You need me because I'm the best writer in all of the universe.
Okay, you're in.
Simon, that's everyone on the list, I'm afraid. You've seen them all now.
But there must be someone who can fill in the last spot.
I can do it, Simon!
Let it go, let it go. I am one with the
wind. That's basically how it went.
And so that was it. His panel was truly complete. But there was still something missing.
Brilliant.
And over the 10 years they spent together, they became the very best friends.
Such a
cute.
Wap-ba-ba-loo-ba.
Simon! Simon! Simon!
Oh, very good.
Well, that was chaos. For brilliant, brilliant chaos.
Been rehearsing that?
2 weeks.
I could have done with another week, but it was brilliant.
David, what did you think?
It was so true to life. Incredible. Very original, very funny, wonderful.
I absolutely loved it. It was hysterical. Look at Simon's hairy chest.
I mean, what can I say? The girls like the hairy chest.
Such a cheeky bunch.
I just wish we got on as well as you did. Well, look, we've now got to vote. Let's start with David.
Let me kick this off with a humongous yes.
So adorable and funny. It's a yes from me, guys.
It's a yes from me.
Now you've got four yeses.
Little Deck looks very confused out there on stage.
Is that the real thing?
On this table over here, I've written over 100 words that describe emotions that people can feel when they watch magic. Amanda, can you please join me up on stage? On your way up, can you please pick up a piece of paper and look at it? Don't let anyone else see and don't tell me.
Okay.
Can you please sit here? Start to mix it, we'll explain what's about to happen. With the help of my friends from the Magic Circle Young Magicians Club.
The Young Magicians Club.
We're going to do some magic that should hopefully blow your mind. Behind us is a framework containing 16 holes that fit a Rubik's Cube exactly. Each of my friends is holding a Rubik's Cube. Which, like you, they're randomly mixing. At any point, Amanda, I'd like you to stop it from your Rubik's Cube. When you do, in a loud voice, please say stop and hold your cube high in the air.
Stop.
Now, Amanda, there are 200 quintillion ways that a Rubik's Cube can be mixed. All the cubes are mixed in a different way that nobody could possibly know. Everyone in the audience, if you've got a phone, can you please switch the torch on and hold it high in the air?
Sometimes I feel like throwing my hands up in the air. I know I can count on you. Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love I need to see me through.
Space remaining. Do you want to mix your cubes some more or leave it as it is?
I'm going to leave it as it is.
Now, before this all began, when you had first sat down with me, I asked you to pick a word. What was that word?
It was love.
Sometimes I feel like saying, Lord, I just don't care. But you've got the love
come and do dance classes here. I love this place. I'm looking for a Skylar Blue.
Yeah, top floor, Studio One.
Lovely, thank you.
5, 6, 7, 8.
30 tells me that you are an amazing dancer and that it's always been a dream of yours to perform on Britain's Got Talent. Is that right? So I'm here to invite you on the show to audition for Britain's Got Talent 2022.
Isn't it?
Are you raring to go? Let's go out. Onto the start and have a little chat with them. Okay?
Good
all
luck.
Yours. Have fun.
There she is.
Oh my God.
This is my little surprise. Yeah. Hello, darling.
Hi.
So, how are you feeling, Skylar?
Amazing.
So this is the lovely Skylar Blue, and I got to go and meet her at her dance class, and I got to surprise her and tell her that she could come and audition on the show this year.
Oh my God.
How old are you, Skylar?
7.
Wow.
So who have you brought with you today, Skylar?
My mum.
Hi, Mum. So you feeling excited?
Yeah.
Yeah, and you're gonna have fun, aren't you?
Yeah.
Right, well, we're all behind you and we wish you the best of luck. So go for it, darling.
Good luck.
Thank
good
you.
Luck, honey. Have fun.
Oh, I imagine how nervous I must be.
You walked with me, footprints in the sand, and helped me understand where I'm going. You walked with me when I was all alone, with so much unknown along the way. Just say, I promise you, I'm always there. When your heart is filled with sorrow and despair, I'll carry you when you need a friend. You'll find my footprints in the sand. I promise you, I'm always there. When your heart is filled with sadness and despair, I'll carry you. You'll find my foot.
What did you think?
Incredible. I mean, really incredible. You have so much talent. The whole routine was just immaculate. Absolutely loved it.
You were so graceful and so expressive. I mean, I'm just bursting, so goodness knows how your mum feels backstage. You did an amazing job.
Good luck to you. Hey, how good was that?
You're this good at seven, my goodness me. Please don't forget us when you're world famous, okay?
Such a big deal, isn't it? At 7 years old, performing on this huge stage in front of all of these people. I can't imagine how you're feeling, but you did so well. You're so talented, and I just can't wait to see what happens with you in your future. So I'm really happy for you, Skylar. Well done, darling. So I'm saying yes.
Skylar, of course.
Yes!
Amanda?
It's a yes from me.
Now you've got four yeses.
Oh, that's adorable, man. What's your name?
I'm Misha from Birmingham.
What's the dream, Misha?
To be a famous singer, an actress, or even a BGT judge.
Oh! The last one's the easiest. And are you going to sing?
I'm going to dance.
Good luck.
Ah, she's cute.
You are the happiest contestant we've ever, ever, ever had.
You are just so adorable.
Thank you.
Clearly, you're born to be on stage.
I just love how you're standing there like butter wouldn't melt. And then we got to see a whole different side of your skill set.
The fact that you're having such a great time, I think, just made us all smile. David, yes or no?
A very easy yes.
Alicia?
I'm saying yes.
It's a yes from me.
It's four yeses, Misha.
Packed up and moving Sam's lab, but to us it's just an outer space. I wonder how long we will stay.
One of the most emotional and courageous performances that I've ever seen on Britain's Got Talent. Every single one of you deserves this. I can see how much emotion there are. So many of you are in tears. I hope they're happy tears, because this evening you have done yourselves proud. I feel so proud of you all. I barely know you, but I just want to give all of you a massive cuddle, because you were brilliant.
All of you were amazing. I think remembering that all of your mums, or actually, yeah, mums and dads are in the armed forces, which is why this choir came together. And if you think about, you know, what's happening in the world right now with the Jubilee, it's so interesting, isn't it, how a bunch of really talented kids can make a much stronger message than a bunch of boring politicians. Right? Because that was everything we would have wanted from you in the finals. I'm so proud of all of you. Congratulations. And I love the song as well, by the way.
Yeah, it was sort of the perfect mixture of vulnerability and strength, because you let yourselves be emotional, because it's a very emotional song, a very emotional message. And I was just looking at it and thinking, you know, every kid watching this at home would want to swap places with you, because you're all heroes too, because you can get up on that stage and deliver that incredible performance.
I just love that you all have each other, and I hope you remain the greatest of friends for the rest of your lives. You are just all beautiful, every single one of you. And like Amanda said, if I could come up there and squeeze you all, give you a big hug, I would. That was wonderful. You should be so proud.
Tonight, I want to show you something using two of the things that I love the most. Toys that are puzzles, but that also activate our imaginations. David, please quickly mix our cube, and when you're done, pass it to Alicia.
Mix it up.
Alicia, mix and pass to Amanda, and finally Amanda, mix and pass to Simon. Whilst you're doing that, let me explain exactly what you're about to do. Now, magic is all about creating random moments in time that make you go, wow. Tonight, I want to hopefully create a few of those moments, starting with that cube that you have been mixing. Simon, you've got the cube that's been completely mixed. There are multi-millions of combinations that are possible, and no one can ever predict exactly how that cube would end up being mixed. Do you want to mix it once more or leave it as it is?
I need to do it one more time.
Okay.
Now I'm ready.
Please put it down on the table and slide it to me. Now we knew just how your cube would end up being mixed, which is kind of crazy and impossible. I know. Look. Sign number one.
No.
Matches.
What?
No!
Yes.
And you're not going to leave this, but sign number six, matches. Not only that, but you knew this before we even came out on stage tonight. We even knew this days ago before you had these t-shirts printed. Look. Possible moments where I look up into the air and say, wow, watch this. Using another favourite toy of mine. Magic. With Lego, I can create anything in my imagination, like a teleportation device. Now I can see Siri thinking, don't be crazy, Rowling, that's not possible. But how cool would that be? Now growing up would think that's not possible, but let me show you that anything is possible. I want you all to watch closely. Remember, you can see under the table at all times. The help of my friends, they're going to create a human chain around this box. They think it go underneath, upwards, forwards or backwards. Watch closely because they're going to do this in one shot with no cuts.
Five, four, three, two, one.
Well done. That was incredible.
My mind is blown.
What about yours, David?
How do they do that?
Oh, well, you clearly have magical powers. I hope you use those powers for good and not evil, because on the strength of that, you can take over the world. I mean, it was brilliant. I mean, just as we thought it was all going to be about Rubik's Cubes, you pull off this amazing magic... I won't say trick, because it wasn't a trick, was it?
Trick.
So what is it? Just magic?
Magic, yes.
You pulled off this amazing piece of magic at the end. Yeah, I thought...
Literally the king of the Rubik's Cube, to stand up here and hold your own in front of this live audience, you did brilliantly well.
Thank you.
Honestly, I'm blown away. Smashed it.
I still just don't know how you did it. I mean, we've seen adults that can't do this kind of thing, adult wizards that don't even touch the sides compared to what you just did tonight. Everybody is so confused.
Brilliant. I had as much fun watching my son Eric with his friends who were like the whole way through. And that's what it's all about. I mean, absolutely brilliant. I mean, by the way, you're 9. I mean, this shouldn't happen. And it was all happening in front of us. I mean, it was incredible.
You can't teach that. You've just got soul. You're like an old soul in a young person's body. And I'm super proud of you, fellow Welling Garden City girl up there. Big up the Welling Garden City. You did an incredible job. Family must be super proud, and we're all very proud of you too. Well done.
Honestly.
Sing me that chorus without the track for a second.
Okay.
Yeah, I want to hear it, because I couldn't hear your voice.
Okay.
Go on.
Shut your mouth, baby, send in a liver. Holy hands, baby, send in a liver.
just because I couldn't really hear your vocal because the track was so loud, there was so much going on. I love the song, and I really, really, really like you, and I think you're fearless, and the fact that you could just do that in the moment, because I really wanted the audience at home just to hear your voice, and you're brilliant.
Because we missed you.
Me?
Yes.
Me, I just want to say I thought it was an extraordinary performance. You're so confident, you just went straight into it. You still feel like you're authentic, you still feel like a kid, that's what we were all saying.
Yeah.
But you have got the biggest voice. I feel like this is the moment we're going to look back when you've got dozens of albums and Grammy. This will be your moment.
How long have I got?
Two words.
Yeah, it was all right. No, it was sensational, and you are a superstar. Everyone else, go home now.
You can put your mind to do whatever you want to do. Just tell yourself that you're capable too. But don't do things that ain't even cool. And get rid of them no good friends that's enabling you. Making you feel like you won't be nothing. Your life crumbling, they talk mumbling. You gon' be something. You are glorious. We're no gangs but warriors. We well known, notorious. They can't stop you or block you or mock you. They mad cause you bad and they not you. You fall down but get up and skip and hop through. Kick down doors for others to walk through. You have a purpose to make you say, did I do that? Urkel. Now we call a reality virtue. This is who I am. This is me. Don't let them words hurt you.
When the sharpest words wanna cut me down, I'm gonna send a flag, gonna drown them out. I am brave, I am bruised, I am who I'm meant to be. This is me.
For you boys. That was absolutely incredible. And I just wish that, like, I was 11 watching this show and seeing you do that on stage and realizing you can be whatever you want to be in life. This goes beyond dance into a beautiful, positive message about how the world should be. It just could not be any better, guys. Well done.
Alicia.
I was enjoying it so much, I didn't want it to end. It was so beautiful. We fell in love with you at the auditions, you had a really strong message, and tonight felt like more of a celebration. Just keep doing what you're doing and inspiring any other young boy out there to follow their passion, just like you have.
So emotional when I saw your first audition, and tonight I felt equally the same. It's just beautiful to watch, inspirational, great choreography, great stage. You worked the whole stage, your message. This show is probably the biggest platform in the country for you to say what you wanted to say. I know you've all been through a tricky time with people at school and people judging you, but if you needed to get that message across, my goodness me, you did that tonight. So well done.
I get it. You know, your audition...
You were telling us your friendship formed because you were bullied at school, and you had the guts to tell us about that. And, you know, if anyone bullied my son, well, seriously, I mean, we all feel the same way. For me, it's one of the most cruel things ever, but that's the negative. Let me come on to the positive. Your audition was, I'm going to call it a 9. This was a 99, actually, because it was like watching your own musical. It was so brilliant. It was so moving. Your choice of music was incredible. And just seeing how much it meant to you at the end, after your performance as well, made it even more special. I can see you still now, and rightly so. But you should be very proud. That was amazing. Thank you, Simon.
My name is Anishwa. I'm 7 years old, and I love the Earth with its beauty untold. I'll show you the planet. You can look through my eyes. We'll start at the oceans, then soar through the skies. In the warm, shallow tropics and waters deep, where the coral breathes life and the fishes sleep, I see a green turtle feeding on a dish. Oh no! It's a plastic in disguise of a jellyfish. I know soon this turtle is gonna fall sick. And it's our job to do something quick. And it's not just the turtles, even the mighty blue whale, unless if we reduce plastic, won't live to tell their tale. Let's go to the beach and think of the land. I love building castles with my dad in the sand. I love watching seabirds build their nests to breathe in the beautiful sea cliffs for their babies to feed. Let's go to the rainforest, which fills me with awe, home to spy monkeys, eagles, and the macaw. Jaguars hunting for peccaries, and sloths moving slowly, holding onto the trees. If I say the man of the forest, you know what I mean. The amazing orangutan, have you ever seen? But if we cut down the trees, how can they swing? It's their home, not ours. What hope can we bring? Why do the tigers have to compete for their space with the bigger and bigger human race? It's so sad to see the lions lose their glory and the elephants fade just for their ivory. All these creatures need our care, else they disappear as we just stare. But come with me to the mountains and look into the sky, because my heart is filled with hope as I see a dove fly right by.
Magical, and this is definitely something that younger people are educating older people like us about. And you put it over so simply, so beautifully, everyone has to take notice. Now, you know, Sir David Attenborough one day may pass the baton to you, because You're in love with the world as much as he is. You're incredible.
Oh, where do we even start with you? You are just too cute. I found that really emotional, actually. It was such a powerful poem, beautifully delivered with fantastic expression and genuine heart. Describing our beautiful planet. Thank you. What a wonderful, wonderful thing to bring to our stage. You did incredible. Feel super proud of you.
Yeah, absolutely. I should say that all our children are here this evening, and I turned around to look at them all, and they were transfixed by your wonderful, confident performance. And it just made me think, as a parent, that we have to do so much more to protect this earth so our children can live in it. And your message was put over beautifully, so well done.
I agree with everything. It was pure, utter magic. And let's remember, you are 7 years old, and there was so much to remember and to time everything with the images. Here's a conversation I think is going to happen from Mr. Attenborough.
Anishwa, I would like you to take over from me doing Blue Planet.
So much.
He can't get enough of
well
it.
Well done, boys. Come on. Well done. Oh, that
amazing.
Was brilliant.
Alicia.
Oh, I love you boys so, so much. Your cheekiness, your friendship, the energy that you brought tonight was fantastic. Apart from the fact that you have great taste in music, I think the biggest motto in life here that we've learned is sometimes in life you fall down, but you get back up stronger. Congratulations, I loved it. Loved it.
It was thrilling, it was exciting, it was brave, and like Alicia said, it's live, so mistakes are going to happen, but you got straight back on, and you smashed it. Well done, I'm very proud of you.
What are you going to say? Where do I start? I mean, again, there was a little spill, but I mean, what's so amazing about you guys is I love your friendship. I love the fact that you really wanted to be in the semi-finals, because I'm not going to lie, we were thinking about this, you know, after what happened last time. Is this the right thing, wrong thing? But, you know, you convinced us you wanted to be here. You put on an amazing show. Importantly, it was way better, I think, than your first audition. The weird thing is, I was out with Eric, my son, today, who's on one of these things, and he said, Daddy, do I have to wear a helmet? Yes. Yes, you do. Yes. And that's why.
Oh, our names on it.
Brilliant. Oh, well, okay, well, I might have to borrow one of those.
And our shoes.
Oh, right, on your shoes as well.
Steve.
Yeah, you're very cool, I've got to tell you.
David, did you like it?
I mean, it was absolutely thrilling from start to finish, and I really think, you know, you shouldn't worry about little slip-ups or anything, because they only serve to make us all realise how difficult what you're doing really is, yeah, and how daring it is. So, you know, don't beat yourself up about it. That was an incredible, incredible performance. And you're a showman as well, which I think is amazing. You know, you're kids, you've got a passion for something, but you know how to put on a show. Well done.
Is our only. I won't give up. I'm here again to continue the conversation, an important lesson for our generation. All I ask is that you sit back and listen while I talk to you about my mission. Instead of dodo, makes me feel sad. Reminds me of all the species we had. The passenger pigeon, the still sea cow, and the big macaw. They're all extinct now. I wish we knew much earlier on, and these beautiful creatures would not have gone. We need to protect the wonderful nature to give us hope for a better future. Don't cut down trees, they're home for ants, robins. And woodpeckers, they're all our friends. We must all stand together and share the information. So please, don't give up on conservation. The earth needs our biggest help. It's tangled in nets and losing its kelp. By eating and recycling with the planet in mind, you can do your bit for all beyond mankind. Let's protect this planet we all adore and keep it safe forevermore. I'm here to continue the conversation, an important message for our generation. Thank you for listening to all my poems.
Message across, and you did it in such a beautiful, animated and confident way, and it just reminded me, you know, again, how big the earth is and how small we are, how small all of us are, but especially you. And but it's a massive message that you're bringing to us every single time, and we have to start listening to our children. Well done.
Thank you.
I think you are honestly a very, very, very special young man.
Yes.
You really, really are. I do. Honestly, every time you tell us one of your poems, I'm sitting here transfixed. I think, honestly, if ITV are watching, which they should be, because we're on ITV. You should have your own. You should have your own show. Honestly, talking about.
When I was rehearsing of the starters being on the chair, I noticed that you had some chewing gum and some glitter under your desk.
Did you see that? Yeah, you're right, Rumble.
Yeah,
I can't believe you caught me out. I did, actually, yeah, and I apologise.
Oh, God. Special light, which actually, to save the environment, he should switch off.
David, what did you think of Anishwa?
Look, you are adorable, but it's a really important message. It's what I love about this act, and your passion really shows through, and it's weird because obviously we keep on being told this, but it takes someone like you to really, really make us sit up and think, and I think the whole country is doing that now, but you should be spreading your message across the world.
Tokyo, and the fact that you memorised this whole thing just shows how talented you are, because it all comes from the heart. I've told you before how much I love you, and you smashed it again. Well done.